everyone, it's Hailey, and today I'm going to be doing a spoiler-free review for Your Welcome Universe by Whitney Gardner. So I received a copy of this for review from Indigo Books and Music, the bookstore that I work at, so thank you so much to them for sending this to me. I was so excited to read it, and I loved it. So this book follows Julia, and Julia is a capital D deaf girl who goes to a school for those with hearing impairment, and she has gone to that school forever, and it's a place where she feels like she fits in. But her supposed best friend ends up selling her out for graffiti, and she ends up getting kicked out of her old school and having to go to a mainstream school, which is basically her worst nightmare. So she goes to this school, and she at least can still escape by doing graffiti. But then someone keeps on drawing over her drawings and improving them, and she's getting really frustrated by this, and so a graffiti war ensues, and along with it, she struggles to find herself and fit in a world where she really doesn't know where she fits in. The writing of this book honestly made it hard to believe that this was a debut because it was so strong. Like, the main character had such a strong and believable voice. It was such a relatable story. And one of the things that I loved the most about this book was how diverse it was. So Julia is Indian and she is deaf and she has lesbian parents. Like, how amazing is that? I just love the fact that it portrayed a modern family that isn't like the families, like the cookie cutter families that you normally see that don't actually exist. It was a realistic family, and I just thought that was so nice to see in YA. And part of what made the representation so great is the fact that it just was. It wasn't the main focus of the story. It was just a fact about our main character, Julia. Just like the fact that her hair is black. It was just something that was a part of her. Just a kind of character trait, something that made her who she was. And it really wasn't like this kind of coming to terms with the fact that she can't hear and she's different. It was more so her trying to find where she fits in the greater sphere of everyone being able to hear and she can't. She was just kind of trying to fit in. She wasn't really struggling to be comfortable with who she was. She was more so just trying to find how the world would let her fit in, if that makes any sense. Also, I'm going to get to that more in plot and characters. I want to get back to writing now. So back to writing, I'm actually going to talk about drawing because this book has illustrations in it which are done by the author and they are amazing. Let me find one. Like, they are so well done and I loved them. Like, I loved them so much. I think there's the one. Yeah, I loved this one because it's like a whole building with graffiti on it, and then this one I really enjoyed as well. Yeah, that one I thought was really cool. It has all sorts of drawings and that just made the story come to life because the story really is driven by art and questions surrounding what constitutes art and what constitutes vandalism. And I thought the fact that this book had illustrations in it just really drove that point home. So now I want to get into the characters. Like I said, Julia was a character that I loved because she's flawed. She is not perfect at all. This was not your kind of cookie cutter, like, special snowflake. She is just, you're not like other girls. Like, it wasn't like that at all. Julia really is her own person and she makes mistakes. She makes dumb decisions. She's not the most likable character, but she really is kind of likable in the fact that she is so relatable and realistic. And you can, like, I felt like I was going back to when I was a bratty teenager who would just do whatever I wanted. So I felt like she was really a character that I could get behind. So aside from the fact that she was this, like, beautifully complex and imperfect and very frustrating at the same time character, she also was not a wounded animal. She didn't want to be pitied. She was so confident in herself and comfortable with who she was. And it was just kind of about her really trying to find how the rest of the world would react to her. It's kind of hard to describe, but it wasn't a story about her being like, oh, like, this sucks. I wish that I could hear like everyone else. I wish that I wasn't different. She embraces her differences and she loves them, and she is proud of her culture, proud of being deaf, and it was just beautiful. Her greatest strength, I think, was the fact that despite the fact that she made some dumb decisions at times, her moral compass was really strong. She knew what she wanted and wasn't afraid to do anything to go and get it and to risk anything. Despite what other people were saying, she knew wrong from right, and she didn't let other people sway her opinion in that. And it was just awesome. Like, and her attitude was just like sparky, snarky. I just loved it. I also loved the fact that this book had no romance, so she wasn't portrayed as the damsel in distress, and it was just awesome. Part of her struggle in this story, I think, was the fact that she doesn't know how to communicate with those who can hear, because she's never had to that much, because she went to a school for those with hearing impairment. So now that she has, like, I think the fact that she still is an artist was beautiful, because she's really using art as a form of communication, because art is truly that. It's a form of communication that transcends any language barriers, and she was using that mode to tell people how she was feeling, and it was just really nice to see such an artist and be in such an artist's mind, because she was just an awesome character. She was also fiercely loyal to her friends, despite the fact that they weren't always the most loyal. My one problem with her was the fact that at times her ex-best friend, her like treatment of her and her thoughts about her kind of weren't like, I didn't really like that, because it kind of, I felt like, bordered a bit on slut shaming, and I wasn't a huge fan of that, but like very much so bordered on it. I don't want to say that it was slut shaming, but it was kind of like, she was a little bit judgmental in that sense, and I do wish that that ex-best friend had been developed a bit beyond the fact that she liked to sleep around a lot. Now the other character that we have is YP, and I'm still so mad that we didn't get a name for her. Like, you never get a name for her, and that's not really a spoiler, but like, it's whatever. She is just known as YP the whole novel, and I just wish that I knew her real name. But anyways, she is like this sweet character that you really feel for, because she's so sweet, but she wants to fit in, and she's doing so in like a very different way than Julia. She really struggles with her weight and her self-confidence, and I do kind of wish that that was dealt with a little bit more, like we kind of delved deeper into it, and that Julia had tried to help her a bit more, like she did, but not in the way that I had hoped for. But overall, YP was just this character who was like so sweet but really naively optimistic, and I think that being friends with Julia taught her a lot of things, because she would say some things that were a bit iffy and Julia would kind of just set her straight about it, which was awesome. So she became a really well-rounded character in the end. Now the plot of this book is entirely character driven. It's not very action packed, and I will admit it did start to kind of drag a little bit through the middle, but I loved the fact that it was surrounding art, like I said, and this graffiti war, specifically the kind of gray area between, is graffiti vandalism or is it art? I thought that was an awesome thing to explore in this novel, and I think that the fact that it was exploring deaf culture along with that was really cool. I thought something that was interesting was the fact that she's so bothered by the fact that someone is drawing on her drawings, and I think it was because it felt like her voice is really coming through with her art, and someone adding to that is like, she won't see it so much as they're adding to what she has to say and amplifying it. She kind of sees it as them trying to silence her, and she's not comfortable with that. And I think it's interesting because she does struggle to communicate so much. I'm really not going to say too much else about the plot because, like I said, this really is a story that is driven by the characters. So I covered most of what I wanted to say in the characters and throughout the whole spoiler-free section. But overall, I ended up giving this book a 4.5 out of 5 stars. I thought it was really awesome, and I think if you're a fan of Simon vs. the Homo Sapiens Agenda by Becky Albertalli, or I'll Give You the Sun by Jandy Nelson, you might really like this book. Honestly, the bottom line of it is it has great, strong characters, strong morals, and it is so diverse, it is awesome. Now, should you read it? If you like books where the characters are really relatable, they are flawed and realistic, and they are not special snowflakes, then I think you would like this. Also, if you really like art, chances are you're going to be a big fan. So that is all for the spoiler-free portion of this review. Now, if you haven't read this book yet, then go and read it and then come back and we will discuss it. Now, like I said in the spoiler-free section, Julia's true self really comes out in her illustrations and all of her drawings and all of her art. And I thought that using that as a form of communication was really cool, especially because she's not really bitter about the fact that she can't, like, hear and that she can't really communicate with people. It's the fact that people don't take the time to learn to communicate with her, and how they go about trying to communicate with her is kind of insulting a lot of the time. And I thought it was interesting to read about that from the perspective of a deaf character, because you see things that you wouldn't think of. Like, for example, the gym incident, which I thought was, like, really heartbreaking. You see YP grabs her hands and, like, the way that she said it, like, I wouldn't put my hand over your mouth, I had never thought of that. Grabbing someone's hands who communicates through sign language is effectively, like, covering their mouth, which is just the lowest thing you can do. And I felt like I said, YP is a character who she didn't mean to do dumb things, but at times she did. And I think that being friends with Julia really helped to educate her, especially in instances of, like, silencing her without meaning to, because, like, I would have lost it if I was someone who communicated through sign language and someone grabbed my hands. Like, no, if you put my hand over my mouth, especially while I'm going off, oh my gosh, I will bite your hand off. But anyways, there was the one point, like, at times, I loved the fact that this book was so diverse, but at times I felt like the fact that she was an Indian character wasn't, like, I wish her culture had come out a bit more, because, like, there was the one incident at when she was working with I don't want Muslim hands touching my food, and that was kind of the only instance of her culture coming out and, like, seeing how that shapes her as a character. And it was, like, don't get me wrong, it was a really disgusting moment. I was, like, sickened by it, because I know that things like that are actually happening now, but I just felt like sometimes she was just, like, it's not a bad thing because we do need diverse characters in YA, but at the same time, sometimes it kind of feels like they're just, like, you're just gonna make that character that ethnicity to add that ethnicity. But I don't know, that's kind of a gray area that I feel like I have mixed feelings on. So I did love the fact that she was an Indian main character, but I wish her culture had come out a little bit more, and I think that would have enhanced the diversity of the story even more. Now, like I kind of mentioned, Jordan was, her ex-best friend, was never developed beyond the fact that she was kind of boy crazy and seemed superficial. I wish that she had gotten the chance to kind of redeem herself, and I think that would have made me like this book some more, because I was kind of uncomfortable with her treatment in this book. Now, the whole time she's trying to figure out who is adding to her graffiti, and I knew for sure it wasn't Donovan, and I wasn't convinced that it was the art teacher Katz. Like, I thought maybe, but I don't know, I just didn't feel like I thought it was just kind of him taking the pictures of the graffiti, was just he likes art. So I don't know. But I never would have guessed that it was YP. Never would have guessed. Like, once again, I'm not the kind of person who sees plot twists coming, but I just didn't think that it would have been her, because she seemed like this just, like, sweet, really easygoing, like, didn't seem like an artist really. So I loved the fact that it was her, because I thought it brought them closer together, even though it kind of tore them apart for a little bit, it brought them closer together in the end. So that's all that I really want to talk about for the discussion. I didn't really have too many things that I wanted to discuss. Let me know if there's anything that you guys wanted to discuss, and let me know your thoughts on this book. Like I said, I did really love it. I had a couple of issues with it, but overall I thought it was a beautiful representation of deaf culture and an awesome addition to YA books. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!